time I have to be concentrated and see our option. I'll get a ball and I already have three ideas what to do. If the ball is here and my brain starts thinking,
it's too late.
Okay, here.
If you play longer, if he's my teammate, I wouldn't pass it like this. I wouldn't do this because if he's doing a mistake, I have to go in. Pass it back. What sometimes happens now that I try, if he's not my teammate, I try to challenge other players. So it's getting also some sort of technical issue because you can challenge the team players wearing other shirts. But basically, I think it's a good preparation. You work in small spaces and you have many touches with the ball and you have actually lots of pressure. That I think is important. You have limited space, no time, just only one touch. You don't have time, only one touch. And usually, three players, they can always get pressure on. So we have all types of space. Time, opponent, and space. Next one we do, we use both players. And we do now something is about switching offense, defense, and defense, offense. Like the orange team has four positions and two green player attack. Only two, only two. And the rest is covered. Okay, just pass it. Try to do it.
How many touch?
Two touch with the fingers. If possible, one, two is also okay. Stop! Just freeze. Once you got the ball, you pass it back to your side. And you pass it. And you move. And two orange players attack. Maximum two touch, if possible one touch. Leon. So now it's orange ball. Orange ball. Because I told you I try to give many examples for different tactical trainings. But I will not tell you what this is about. I will explain the exercise, but I will not say this is for this, this is for this. You have to tell me after, because you can watch it actually. Not the players, just the coaches outside. And I'm sure you can tell me what this is about. Okay, in the blue square, each team, we have free touch at the beginning. No special room, they can touch the ball as many times as they want. But I would say it makes sense, small game, to get some ball spin at the dribble all the time. They can actually use this player as a neutral player. He will always pass the ball back to the team he got it from. Very easy. Pass back. And I think all the players here already have good skills. So these neutral players, always one touch. Neutral player, one touch. We have another neutral player here in the middle who can also use. For example, I'm orange now. I pass, he drops, and the next ball will be that one. And then we all move to that side of the pitch and the match goes on. Which means both teams have to move. The team in ball possession and of course the team without. It's not allowed that this pass is not allowed. I don't want to see. Just one, two. This is not allowed. It must be pass, drop, and it can also be I pass and maybe there's no bonus just there. And you drop to him, and long ball. Also possible, and we all have to move up, because for him it's a technical exercise actually, because remember, one touch. So we need to quickly move up to get the ball back. Okay. So basically, because usually nobody's covering here, we try to play a low pass. Because if I pass it like this, we will have problems to do it with one touch and it's sort of pointless. You don't need to play a high ball if there's no opponent. So that's the basic rules. It's actually also, I don't must. It's not a must. You pass, you drop it. if I don't want, for whatever reason, for example, he's a player, I don't have to. I can play on that side. It's up to me. It's one option. I don't have to. Okay. Any questions? Okay.
Hey, hey, hey!
Might be difficult. So if it's thinking about a pyramid, the basic skill is the first one, just inside passing with pressure. And this, if we have this level, we can go on doing the tactical things. So, but I'm not talking about you. You're technically okay, so we can do this sort of exercise. But still, we could see if there was pressure by time, space, and opponent, some players struggling using the proper technique. So it's up to you. Changing offensive, it's about opening the game. I get the pass, and the pressure is coming. We cannot play on here forever. The ball will be gone, it will be gone for the other team. So one day I have to, or one moment I have to open the game. So this exercise was, of course, technically aspect was ball position within pressure situations. It was about switching, because many times they have to switch from defense to offense. But very important is that this game is opening the game. And this is really important. If you have ball position and you get the ball here, usually the whole players, my teammates and other teams here. And you manage to open, you have a fair chance for a counter attack. So it's about opening the game. As a final game, do one triple goal, one big goal. I personally think everybody likes scoring on the big goal much more than dribbling or passing. So I think it's important to change. One half, the blue team, for example, attacks the big goal, and then the swap. I think it's very important because I think all football players like scoring on the big goal more than scoring pass goal or triple goal. To summarize, I think I already explained we did something today, switching offense defense, we did something to open the game, and finally I tried to create a situation between neutral players where we have many changes of all positions
and we have to move quickly back to defense. The thing is, the technical ability must be there. If the players have no technical ability to control, to pass, it's pointless to want them to play very difficult tactical systems. First, always technique, and then tactic. The other way around is very difficult. So it's first of all, you need to control the technique, and then you can expect them to open the game. For example, if they cannot pass about 25 meters or they can't control it, it's pointless to tell them to tackle the game with opening the game.
One thing which was very obvious today, we already spoke about it. Now, some of you, of the coaches who played today, were not active players. Now, if you would be a Premier League team or a team, I would say you have one problem. The technical ability, most of the players have. But technique alone, meaning passing, juggling, doing tricks, there's not a game of football yet. There is not a lot of it. One of the weaknesses, and we both agree on that, we saw so far, is the next step. Sometimes we wait for the ball. Once the ball is there, we start to play. But the game without the ball, that's exactly the right word. Your game without the ball needs to improve. Meaning, looking into England, or looking into Germany, the players are always moving. The ball is on the left side. They know where to move because they can already have the anticipation to get the ball. The national team in Africa, for me, the tactics, the technical skills, or especially the physical condition, were very good. But sometimes they didn't know what to do all the time. For the players it was, I get the ball and then I play. Which is sad, that's not it. So, if you're a coach and you want to improve the technical understanding of each player, what I always did before every national game, I'm talking about national players, they played everywhere, they played in Belgium, they played in Switzerland, they played in South Africa. I gave my, let's say he's my left back. I gave my left back one day or 2 days before the game. I gave him a little piece of paper where I wrote him down what I, as his coach, expect from him in the next game. But if the best team plays against the lowest team, or a small team plays against the medium team, I expect every single game from every certain position something different. Meaning, if I have a top team and I play against a small team, I want my two wing backs, my two full backs, they need to attack. But if I am a small team and I play against the top team, the most important thing for my full backs is to make sure not much happening on their side. So before every game, I wrote them down what I expect from them on a tactical basis.
I don't think I can explain it differently. Five things you need to do when you're a coach educator or a coach. Again, we had a list of 10 or 12.
tijd te doen. We gaan die nog eens omleggen. Goeie goed, hè. Mijn neer, ga dat toe. Nu laat mij eens gedaan. Heb je zo, John?
Op het weer, op het weer.
Ik zei ja, dat is niet goed.
Me up to the power, old man.
Come on!
six of you can talk, but it's the best preparation for your individual talks, because you have some ideas. But tomorrow we will have one problem. The problem will be that, number one, we are 26 or 27, I think 26. We are 26 coaches. And each of you will get one individual task. The problem will be that I try to help you that you're doing two or three at the same time. But obviously, let's say he will be number one, he's number two, he's number three. The number five, you cannot repeat the same exercise. If I could lock you in a room somewhere here, right? I would do that because then you don't see. But if we know that you see, and you know, even if you don't copy, you do copy. So do we have a solution that we can lock them somewhere? Maybe to the army guys or something.
Or inside, I mean,
is there room inside?
Yeah, there's a room inside.
Then you will be, some of you will be in the rooms because I only want to help you to be in the rooms, otherwise I have to say no, you bound to this to another one. No, this one must stand to another one. In the end you're running, you're getting nervous. So it's better for you to be in the room, if you do the same exercise. If you didn't see it, it's not a problem. We already had a little look at the written examination and I did 20 people I already did, but I only did 8 questions so far. And it looks very, very good. So I think, I'm actually right now, we were like discussing, you prepare yourself very, very well. That's the way it looked like, because I don't think that you copy from each other because you were too far away. So it looked to me very good. So the way it looks right now, the 20 I looked at, they definitely have done it already because everybody is quite high. The last 8, I will know in the next 2 hours.
Catch!
It counts, it was okay.
Okay, catch!
Go on, do
it! Head! Catch! Catch!